evening of music with all of you, and includes some friends and family and people who I believe woke up at 12 a.m. our time to catch a flight from Michigan, so thank you very much. We also like to thank, of course, USD, Dr. Young, and Evelyn and Gloria and everyone at the FanFaire Foundation for making this evening possible. I want to give just a little, maybe a guide or a little bit of what to listen for when we play the Beethoven. You know, when we think of Beethoven pieces in C minor, probably what jumps to everybody's mind is. And I think one of the great things about Beethoven is he is able to take just those simple four notes, really, and turn them into something so recognizable. I mean, that entire piece, if you think about just the first 8 seconds, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and it keeps going on, right? That's all he does. He really likes those really short themes. And what you're going to hear in this, even from the very beginning, and then right after that, so you hear a lot of. He'll take that theme. Sometimes he'll do it in opposite directions. So, and you'll hear it all throughout. That's one of the things he does. That's very characteristic of Beethoven. Another thing you'll hear that in the last movement. One of the very prominent themes, and you'll hear this part, you might hear this part, and you might hear it together, and you might hear it at the same time. So it's definitely a feature. The second movement is a theme in variations. The piece is in four movements. It's pretty typical of standard trios at this time and after Beethoven. The second movement is a theme in variations, and if, for those of you who are not familiar with it, a theme in variations, so if I were going to do that, compose one on Happy Birthday, of course I'm going to do that. And go on. Then you might do something like. Or something like that. And then you might throw in something to mix it up. You know, I'm not sure what kind of birthday this would be, but. So you get the idea. It should be recognizable. There's a theme in there, but he plays with it quite a few times. This one doesn't end quite like that. And the third movement is a minuet. Minuet is a traditional. It's a dance in three, like a waltz. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. And just to give you a taste, it starts like this. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1. What Beethoven does a lot, and this again very characteristic, he'll, instead of the 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, do I often expect, he'll do 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1. So there's actually the ending of the first part, instead of 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, he'll do 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2. So it kind of displaces the beat a little bit. If it feels a little bit unsettled, that would be why. But overall, works quite well. It's a bit of a surprise ending, as I wrote in the notes, so you will get a chance to make your own opinion about it. But it definitely would have taken the audience at the time by surprise. So this is the Beethoven Trio in C minor. I'm just gonna sort of